went to an AFLW game recently, and on the way out, I ran into a friend, and she said to me, oh, did you come to this game because it's the Pride round? And I assume she asked me that because I'm gay, and it's fine if you didn't pick that about me. I'm not wearing a denim vest, so I did trick you. There were rainbow flags everywhere. Like, everything had a rainbow flag on it. I just hadn't noticed because AFLW seems always that gay. I'm like, what's special about AFLW having a pride round? Is every single player just turned into the one straight girl on the team before the match, just being like, just so you know, Stacey, tonight's about us.
Yes, Stacey, tonight's not about you. Please welcome Alex Ward. We obviously love that clip. The audience love that clip as well. But I do understand that you and your fiancé, Hannah, you're not exactly displaying pride flags around, are you? What's going on?
Yeah, we're not flying the flag, but that's just because we have an issue on our street at the moment. So I do the bins for the neighbour because she's an older lady and it just helps her out.
Lovely human.
And she's very grateful. She's always thanking me. But I saw her a few months ago and she thanked me and she said, oh, thanks for doing the bins. And I said, oh, I was like, oh, Hannah did them, my girlfriend. I'll give her the credit. I said, Hannah did the bins. And she goes, oh, yeah, Hannah. Your daughter. What? Because we've lived there for 3 years. I was like, what? And she's like, Hannah, that little girl you live with. And just to be clear, she's not a child. 3 years younger than me. So I don't know what this woman was saying, but I kind of freaked out. And I went to tell her the dynamics of it and just nothing came out. Because I was like, it's been 3 years. I couldn't do it. So when she said that, I just went, huh, yep.
Yeah. I got to say, she doesn't look like your child.
Oh, we got a photo.
Yeah,
we got
a photo. You're a little bit taller.
Yeah, I wouldn't say she's...
Yeah, no. Yeah. See, why am I the mum? Put me in the bin. But after that, so we were just kind of like, oh, I guess we'll just hide it a little bit. And then once we were walking in, Hannah went to put her arm around me, but I saw the neighbour out the front. So I was like, get off me. And then the neighbour saw that and I was like, well, now I just look like a bad mum. Like, there's no winning.
There was
no
win.
Yeah, yeah. I'm always trying to make Hannah wear a Frozen dress. I'm like, get out there.
I just picture you just trying to fit her into a baby Bjorn. Just like, get in, it'll be fine. I can do it.
Maintain the illusion.
Hey, I love the PR that you have, where you describe yourself as rich and admired. I mean,
yeah,
wow.
I should clarify, rich in terrier dogs. I've got a couple and admired just by those terrier dogs.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, I think you got cut short off the script there.
Well, it's an excellent editing job. Well done.
Yeah, thank you.
Mate, it's lovely to see you. We've been gigging together recently, including some gigs at the Opera House. Very funny. But I hate to do this to you. We brought you in, we've made you watch a clip of your own stand-up, which
loved
can be
it.
Brutal.
So funny.
And now I'm going to bring up a review that you got.
Oh, okay.
I just want to draw your attention to
this. Did you write this?
The Age. No, The Age. Ooh. Says, Ward's trajectory is spiralling vertically, but it doesn't actually say whether it's going up or down.
Okay.
So I assume it's one of those words where you hear spiralling and you think it's like riddled. You're like riddled with success.
Yeah, I could be a rising star or a falling star.
Still a star?
Yeah, still a star. I remember that review. Most of it was about a guy who had an annoying laugh in the audience. Like, it was so little about me, which I liked. I was like, yeah, focus on someone else.
I feel like that sums up the world though, right? It's like, all I could think about was that really loud man.
I was like, yeah, we wouldn't want laughing at a comedy show.
Hey, you're performing at the Replay Festival, which is a great festival at Comedy Republic, great comedy venue in Melbourne. And we heard espresso martinis will not be allowed in the room. Why not?
Just because I can't be near them. I'm banned.
Oh.
You've had
they were my favourite drink. Do you like them, Georgie?
I do. Yeah.
Okay,
I do
well,
like
maybe
them.
You're stronger than I. I found out I can't handle them. Like, I've only ever had one and I was like, great. But then this one night I went a bit further and had a few and no, after the second I was like, yeah, okay, I want to fight. I'm sorry, that changed who I am. Like, by the third, I remember I just lost it completely. I was at the bar and I was like, can I have a drink? The bartender was like, can I have a drink? I was like, well, that's a bit rude. They're like, that's a bit rude. And I was like, oh, it wasn't the bar. I'd just been in the mirror for about 20 minutes. Because it's coffee and alcohol. I don't think we should combine those. That sounds like a class A drug. It's like, makes you depressed with energy. Don't feed them to tiny women. You'll just cry faster.
So, well, hopefully no one will be crying at the show. No espresso martinis. My understanding is, though, that you will be talking about your parents. They may feature in some of your material, particularly yeah, your dad. So yeah, is he funny? Did you get the comedy bug from him?
He's funny, not on purpose. he's driving me insane. He's learning computers, so he calls me a lot.
Oh, no.
And, yeah, he's really bad. Like, he called me the other day, and I barely answered. I was like, hello. He's like, yeah. He goes, I'm sitting at the computer. He goes, I need to prove I'm not a robot. And he goes, I don't have much time. I was like, what? And he goes, I'm looking at the squiggly words. So he's looking at, like, the capture image.
Yeah.
And he goes, have you seen it? I was like, no, that's how those work. I've never seen one of those. And then, because sometimes you just can't help him. It's too hard. Because then he said, how do you type the lowercase six? I was like, I don't know, press six softly. I hung up on him. So he does feature quite a bit. There's some like family stories about growing up, and my dad features strongly in those, and a lot about him learning the computer.
Yeah,
as well.
The term learning computers is just a very funny phrase. Learning computers.
Well, for all of your comedy gold and also some IT support, make sure that you do see Alex's new show. It's called You're Welcome. Well, it's playing at this year's Replay Festival. Tickets are on sale now. All the details on our website. Alex,
come
thank you so much.
Come see me spiral.
Yes. Yes. You be the judge this way.